Jody Grunden, as one of the pioneers in creating a distributed CPA firm, what can you tell us about how to make it through current conditions?
So the kind of unique thing about it is we've been distributed or working remotely for about, since 2013. So we've been doing it for a long time. And so as a CPA firm, it's going to be really important that you, as your team is working from home, assuming that they are working from home, that they're properly equipped, even if it's going to be for a short period of time. We don't really know how long this is going to last, but let's make sure that they have the equipment in place, you know, the multiple monitors, if they're using multiple monitors at work, make sure that they get their monitors and use multiple monitors at home. You know, the chair that they sit in is extremely important. You know, the internet, make sure that they've got the right internet speed. You know, anything, any obstacle that they would have had from working from home, you got to get rid of that obstacle and make it so that so that they really don't notice the difference. And that's going to be one of the biggest things as a CPA owner to make sure that your team is well prepared to work from home, because you never know how long this is going to last. It could be a month, it could be a week, it could be, you know, couple months. We don't know. And so make sure that it's a good experience for them and not just an experience.
When people are working from home, what can you tell managers about how to manage people differently when they're working at home?
Yeah, I think you're going to find out right away that the team's going to be more efficient. They're going to get things done quicker, faster, and better because there's less distractions than it would be at the office, where it's easy to just pick up and grab a cup of coffee and walk to the person next door and chit-chat for a little bit. You typically don't have that from home. So that's going to be one thing, is you will notice efficiency improvements. But the other thing is that your mindset's going to kind of have to shift from a clock-in, clock-out mentality to a get-the-job-done mentality. So it's more of a task-driven versus a time-driven scenario. So, you know, for our team, you know, we really don't care. You know, we want the team to be available during the 8 to 5, and especially during this time of year with the coronavirus and everything. We want to make sure that they're available for clients, but we don't typically care if they clock in at 8 and leave at 5. You know, they may clock in at 8, leave at 10, come back in a couple hours, you know, then work till 7. You know, that should be the mentality, is that you really shouldn't care on the time itself, but care that the tasks are completed and that the clients are covered, you know, because that's the biggest part of this whole thing, is to make sure that the clients are taken care of and their experience is no different or even better, you know, when you're working from home.
Let me ask you about what's going on right now. Based on the feedback you're getting from clients, based on what you see going on in the business, how bad is it?
How bad is it? So we work with a lot of creative agencies. They seem to be not getting hit as hard. There's a lot of delays happening in the field. And some of our creative agencies, depending upon the niche that they're in, are going gangbusters. Food industry would be a perfect example of that. So it kind of varies a little bit there. With the out of the market industry, so like maybe the restaurant industries or, you know, anything that of that nature, they're getting hit pretty hard. You know, they had to let go pretty much their entire staff to make sure they keep their doors open. So in the same thing with the entertainment industry, we've, you know, clients in that industry, same thing, you know, where they've had to let go 300-400 people, put them on furlough. Hopefully they'll come back, you know, in a couple months, and never know, but, you know, that's kind of the predicament they're in. So the biggest thing that we're seeing overall, though, with all of our clients, is they're, especially last week, it was pretty much a scare. You know, everybody's really nervous, not sure what to do. Emotions are driving a lot of decisions. And since we've been able to talk to all of our clients and settle them down, I think this week is more of a, okay, so what's the next step? You know, how does this process work? You know, we've got a pretty good warm, fuzzy feeling now that we've looked at our scenario planning and knowing that the world's not going to come to an end in most cases. And we've decided, hey, here's what we have to do as the next step. Now, what's the government's, you know, action going to take, and how's that going to improve our position? Is that going to allow us to keep our people? Do we have to let some of the people go? You know, those are the types of decisions that they're making now versus, you know, wow, am I going to go out of business tomorrow? You know, that was the decisions last week. We had to calm down. This is the decisions more in the planning stage this week. And I'm sure that will continue on to next week, where everybody's really looking and seeing, hey, how can I, you know, what if this scenario does happen? You know, what's my steps going to be? You know, if the scenario 2 happens, now what are my steps and action points going to be? And so now they're logically thinking through them, so that if it does happen, the emotions is taken out of it completely. And now they're actually, you know, doing what's best for the company.
You specialize in CFO outsourcing services. What do clients need from you now?
Clients need reassurance. Clients need to know that you're on top of it. They need communication. You know, if, you know, with our clients, we want to make sure that we've spoken with everybody at least twice a week. You know, all of our clients need to at least hear from us twice a week, and then dropping them an email and follow through with what we talk about. So if we said, hey, we're going to get back and find out about the question that they had, make sure we do. You know, that's the important thing. And so the communication is really important, that we're talking with them. We're looking at their short-term needs, their short-term cash flow. We're looking at their, you know, over the next 3 months. But more importantly, we're making sure that the decisions they make today does not adversely impact, you know, what happens when this is all over, because it will be all over. And that's the key there. And so what we want to make sure is that, hey, we don't do something today that, you know, it's going to hurt them in October, you know, hurt them in November, hurt them in December, you know, that type of thing. So we're looking at the global picture and adjusting it based on, you know, what we do know, and letting them know that what we don't know, we'll get back with them, you know, tomorrow or the next day when we have a better clear picture and how things are flowing.
When this is all over, what will the world look like?
Yeah, it's kind of interesting because before, you know, we've always promoted that we want to maintain cash in the bank, you know, at least 10% of your annualized revenue in the bank at all times, and up to 30%, which equates to about 2 to 6 months worth of cash. And a lot of times, you know, people are like, oh, that'd be great. I wish I had that. And they just never can seem to build that cash, you know, because there's always something else that comes up that's more important. Well, I think now they're realizing why they need it, because it's hit them right in the face. And it's like, okay, well, the reason why you need 6 months is so you don't have to make those harsh, you know, rash decisions. So after this is all over, I think what you're going to see is you're going to see that, hey, you know, their goals are kind of lie more into what it really takes to run an effective company. You know, hey, you need to build cash, and here's why you need to build cash. You need to have this on hand because of many different reasons that could happen. You know, if they're going to tighten things up, you know, you'll find that a lot of things that maybe they didn't really need to have in their company, they're going to get rid of. They're not going to use. Maybe it's subscriptions that have been going on forever that they just didn't take the time to do it, or, you know, whatever that might be. So they're going to run a more efficient company, and they're going to find ways to, you know, to build that cash. Cause that's the only way that you can, you know, build cash, is if you run an efficient company. And so I really see that to being a big thing for clients, or for, you know, basically for the world in general, you know, the small businesses in general. They're going to run a more efficient, you know, more, and stay more on top of their finances, so that if something does happen, because it will, something will happen down the road, hopefully not like this, but, you know, there'll be bad things that they'll be able to handle and be more prepared when they go into it.
You talk to a lot of accounting firms on a regular basis as well, because you have a robust coaching program for accounting firms. There's going to be winners and losers among accounting firms. Who are going to be the winners, mm-hmm. and who are going to be the losers?
Winners and losers. The losers are going to be those that can't adapt to the technology. Technology is there for sure, and you've got to be able to adapt to it. A lot of times when we talk to accounting firms and they ask us, you know, how did you go distributed? And we tell them our story and how it works really well. And then I hear in the background, well, we couldn't do that. And it's like, at the time, it's like, okay, yeah, you're right. You're not going to be able to do it if you don't believe you're going to do it. Now they're kind of forced to do it. And so they're trying to figure it out. And so if they can figure it out, if they can adapt to it, I think those are going to be the winners when it comes down to it. Because that'll translate to many parts of their business outside of just, you know, being able to work from home. You know, using technology and using adapting to the changes is really the key, I think, really to any successful company. So for those that are still going to, you know, figure out ways to make this a bad deal, you know, figure out ways to complain about the situation versus trying to figure out, hey, how are we going to make this into something that we can really benefit from, you know, that's going to be the winner and loser. So it's going to really come down to the attitude of the owner when it comes down, when everything boils down to it, you know, what type of attitude is that owner have with this thing? Is it a bad situation? Is it a good situation? You know, can I turn this bad situation into a good situation? Those are the ones that are going to come out on top for sure.
Anything else I should be asking you about what we're going through and how to get through it?
You know, I think the biggest thing is just as a provider, I think it's more of our duty than it is, you know, something to make an extra buck. It's our duty to help these people through this situation, help the clients through the situation, whether they're paying for that service or not. It's kind of our obligation, I think, as CPA firm owners. So, as we go through, we've got many different levels of services that we provide our clients, but, you know, for those that own businesses, they're getting contacted, you know, we're there to help them out even in this need. And I think that itself will lend, you know, a client forever, you know, down the road. You know, they may never convert to a CFO service. They may stay as a tax return client. That's cool. We don't have any problem with that. But just simply reaching out to them and helping them out, I think, really goes a long way, and especially a long way with the community.
Jody Grunden, Summit CPA. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks, Rick.